Wow, what's up everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and today I'm back another clip with the conversation I had with Sir Love. And the primary topic of this conversation is one of the big differences between artists who have longevity and those that don't. And we even do a little bit of exploring on the type of artist you'll probably see here going forward into the future. So let's go ahead and hop into that conversation. I'll see you at the end. This, in a sense, just to be short and less eloquent with it, music bubble that could potentially be happening.
I think we're going to see hit records and we're going to see hit artists. Mm. And there's going to be a separation between the two. It's going to be people that make trendy records and it's going to be people that make timeless records. Because right now, in today's world, you're going toe-to-toe with the greats. Right now, I have a choice of listening to you or Tupac, you or Biggie Smalls, you or Michael Jackson, you or Elvis Presley, you or Madonna, you or, you know, whoever I want to bring up, Taylor Swift, Katy Perry, Beyonce, you know. So, you know, there's going to be certain artists that you listen to for a season. There's going to be other artists that you listen to for a lifetime. And that's going to change the trajectory of how artists survive in this game. I think you're going to see the hit artists take longer to reach that level of success. And I think you're going to see trendy artists going to come in quick and leave quick. There's going to be a few trendy artists that are going to be able to make a transition into adding value. It's very hard. The difference between trendy and, in my opinion, the long-term artists are going to be the ability to be current enough to be trendy in reference to your style, your delivery, your flow, your beats, your content, but also to have content that means something to where I would want to hear this same message 5 years from now.
Right. And the way I think about that from a marketing standpoint is there's a difference between marketing, which usually lends towards awareness, and then actual value, which is your brand. Right. And if you can't create value and create a brand, then you're in trouble. As a matter of fact, Coach K, Rat Radar podcast interview. He was really heavy on talking about Yachty and that brand, right? Yachty is a cash cow because he is a brand. And he even talked about if you can't create a brand around the artist, from a manager standpoint, you're doing something wrong. Or that artist, even if they have a hot track, but I can't create a brand around that artist, there's nothing there, then he wouldn't look into it as something worth investing in. And that's because your longevity is really brand-based, not music-based.
100% agree. If you look at people like Snoop Dogg in the game, Snoop Dogg, if you look at him from a record sales perspective, in the time period that he was selling those records, he's not the greatest of all time. He's not in that conversation, I don't think, when it comes to sales. But when it comes to brand and all the different areas that this guy has reached out to and the impact he's had on the community, whether that's been his, you know, Girls Gone Wild series, that's been the movies written about him, that's been the television show he had, that's been the football coaching thing, that's been all the movies that he's been in, that's been, I can keep going. You can talk about Snoop for a long time because it's brand elevated. LL Cool J, brand elevated. Queen Latifah, brand elevated. Will Smith, these are all guys that went to film. But then you can also talk about, you know, other people that have established a history of just making great records. Gucci Man, for example, is a person that's just been able to supply you with hit records over and over and over and over the course of time. And because of that, he's been able to sustain himself in the game. If you look at Jay, he branded himself as a boss early on. Reasonable Doubt, he was a boss on the streets. Yep. Now today, he's still a boss, but I'm an executive boss. And he stayed with the brand that kept him, you know, even though he dropped albums like Kingdom Come, you know, you know, he was still able to bounce back. You know, he retired, came
like
back.
Like bosses do.
Like bosses do. So, and then there's other artists that were just really, really great and just didn't have, you know, that same longevity. I don't want to call any of these guys out because I think that's effed up. But, there's a lot of talented artists that we would go, man, what happened to him? Why didn't they, you know? But, you know, I think branding separates you from trendy records.
Exactly. It gives you that ability to survive even when it's not hot out there musically. So one thing that I really want, well, actually two things. First, one thing we talked about, where the music industry is going, how things are looking positive, especially for the cash to be available. And then we talked about branding, right, and the importance of creating value to separate that from the music. So one thing I want you to take out of the branding portion of it is think about it this way. Branding is really intellectual property. If you guys seen the other video I've done with Sir, we I don't know which order I'll show these things, but did another video with Sir where we're basically talking about how you need to trademark all your brand and own your brand, your name, all that kind of stuff. He mentioned Snoop Dogg. That's a perfect example of intellectual property. Snoop Dogg's character has basically been licensed out in the exact same way that a Marvel superhero has. is the exact same thing. And, and Lil Yachty is going to be the same way, I can guarantee you, because he's had such a strong character and sense of character with Khalifa. There's going to be a lot of brands and for hip-hop. And as a matter of fact, that will be a lot of people's nostalgia. In the same way Marvel Comics came up and we were able to create these worlds and go into these worlds, you're going to see some more movies of these artists in the future in 10 years when the people who grew up on it. Intellectual property, your brand is your intellectual property. That's what you need to spend a lot of time creating.
And let me tell you guys something about a brand. This is a great way to know that you have a good brand. If you can dress up like said person on Halloween, they have a good brand.
Yep.
That's a perfect, simple way to think about it. If you are building your brand and someone can't say, I'm going to dress like you, and it's a distinctive look, and 10 other people would know exactly, you know, how to dress like you, then you haven't established a brand. There's not a physical style. There's not a physical swag. There's not a tone. There's not a, there's nothing that's separating you from everybody else.
Yep. That's so well said. That, the visual, and I even say to a lot of artists, this is a slightly off, but it's the same thing in a sense of having your own perspective and way of saying things.
Yep.
There's certain things, if I say something a certain way, you're going to be like, oh, you're acting like certain artists.
For shizzle, my nizzle.
Obviously, like Snoop Dogg is like the holy grail when it comes to branding and how that his whole situation has worked out. So
Snoop, E-40.
It's how you present and deliver, like lyrically, but also the actual visual aspect. Like you said, dress like that artist. So once again, I mean, you guys already know, right? I love brand man Sean, obviously. but keep all those things in mind. Figure out what that means for you. Everybody has their own situation. Hey, some people, you might just want to have a hit, right? I guarantee you in the future, some people are going to have like songs that are popping, getting millions, but it'll be normal to just maybe be a school teacher and have a hit song. But
yeah.
There, but you don't even think about pursuing a career. It's just a song that's popping because we're going to be used to this quote unquote viral culture that has seemed so new to us. So you got some final words?
Final words. I definitely say I agree with what you just said in reference to you're going to see a more dynamic approach to, you know, teachers and things of that nature making records, because records are no longer going to be about what's good, what's bad. We're not going to be critiquing them in the same way in the future. I think music is going to be about what's funny, what makes me feel good, what makes me laugh, what makes me smile. Music has always been about emotion, and I think that emotion is going to lead. Prior to, there were entities in place such as labels who were gatekeepers and decided which emotions you were allowed to feel. And in the future, you know, if a person wants to make a funny comedy record and it goes on to sell millions and they make a comedy album and it's all funny,
that's a perfect example. And a lot of artists and especially old heads might be like the value of music. In some senses, music will be consumed in the same way that memes have been consumed, right? Yeah. You might say, oh, that was a good meme, and they have their little run, but you don't have any additional expectations of it. You hear a song, it's funny, it's whatever. You hear it, you love it, y'all laugh, hearty har, move on, keep moving, and everybody... They don't even expect a career or anything else to come out of it. And that's just going to be an interesting reality.
Kermit got a nice little career going on. What a meme right now. Kermit got a little career going.
Kermit keeps reinventing himself.
He was sipping tea. Now he's in the mirrors.
So some days he got hoodies on. Man.
He got gangsta.
That's crazy. See, and that's IP right there, man. See, they're going to probably figure out a way to get money out of memes. Actually, there was a situation where somebody... stopped other people from using them in memes, which is a whole other thing.
Arthur. I think it happened with Arthur.
Okay.
Because they got really upset that they were using, because it was all sexual and it was supposed to be a kid show.
Okay. Yeah. The ability to track, it's going to get crazy, man. We can go off and talk about these things forever. We'll just have to get Sir back on the channel, because I definitely always have a good time chopping it up with Sir. Hey, you guys, make sure you follow Phase 6 Sir Love. Check out phase6.com. I probably said what you were going to say, but you got something else that you want to tell
them? I was going to say Phase VI, man. I talk about the music, the business, the money, the paperwork, and things of that nature.
And he motivates you as well.
Yeah, there's definitely some motivational content on there if you guys are trying to figure out how to stay true and stay focused on this game, man. It's all about success. I think there are not enough resources online such as this channel right here, so I encourage you guys once again to binge watch this content. Go to Phase VI, binge binge watch that content, go to Brandman Sean's website, go to my website, see all the extra stuff. We're really committed to helping people like yourself in this game get W's, man. W's. I love seeing young people win. Old people, everybody. I just want to see everybody win, man. Hey. So that's it, man. Go ahead and close them out, bro.
All right, man. If y'all like this video, which y'all better, hit that like button. Share it if you like it as well. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.